So, hello, for those who doesn't know me, my name is Gabriel Massey. I'm a senior CC++ developer at 101 Company, Mail and Media Department. My main task here is to integrate Collabora Online into our online office applications. And today I will talk about stability and cleanup improvements in online. As some of you already know, our company provides cloud services, which means that the users are able to store, retrieve documents from our servers. Also, it provides features of viewing and editing those documents. The view feature is provided through Online Office Viewer application, which is based on Collabora Online and uses its Convert to REST API. The files are converted to PDF and then displayed in browser. The edit feature is provided through Online Office Editor application, which is also based on Collabora Online and provides the entire set of editing capabilities of Collabora Online. These new applications are also used by mail attachments for viewing editing attachments. So let's talk about a little bit about the scale of the deployment. So the deployment of each of these of the applications consists of more than 100 code instances. Combined, they perform more than 600,000 conversions in 24 hours in Viewer. In the editor, more than 35,000 documents are edited in 24 hours, and more than 600 parallel documents are edited at the same time, of course, parallel. So such a scale of deployment needs a powerful and robust mechanism of deployment, scaling, and management. That's why we use Kubernetes. From Kubernetes perspective, we have a single instance of Collabora Online per each pod. So at the end, we have more than 100 pods for each application. Again, this scale of deployment means that there could be some stability and performance issues, and indeed we experienced both of them. As you know, Collabora Online is based on LibreOffice, which is a very complex application and which is constantly evolving and so on. So for any developer, it's not something unusual to experience such kind of issues. However, if we take into account the scale of the deployment that I just already discussed about, the weight of these issues increases significantly. So we experienced crashes. Some of them were solved and shared with community. Most of them were solved by community. Yeah, some of them are still there, probably will be solved in the future. Also, we experience performance issues like abnormal CPU usage and memory consumptions. We've seen that most of the sources of these issues are located inside core, which, as you know, is loaded inside a kit process. So the question is, how do we deal with these kind of issues? Well, there are multiple approaches that can be used to solve them. Of course, the ideal approach is to solve the underlying issues, but this is something that is time and resource consuming and is never ending because of the constant evolution of the application. At any time, a new problem could appear because a new code was committed and so on. Another approach is to use Kubernetes. This means that problematic pods can be restarted. But this solution has some drawbacks. For example, if a pod has 30 kit processes and only one single kit process does all the mess, then by restarting the pod, all the other kit processes will be killed, and the users that have documents opened inside that pod will experience reconnections, they will lose their edit context, and so on, which is, from user perspective, is very unpleasant. The third approach is to implement an automatic cleanup mechanism that destroys only the problematic kit processes. From our point of view, the last approach seemed the most simple, fast to implement, and efficient one, which can deal even with new issues that can appear as the application evolves. So we split the problematic kit processes into two categories: kits that are still referenced by LulWSD and kits that were lost by LulWSD. This is because each category needs a different approach. Those that are still referenced by LulWSD could still process some user input, so they need a more careful approach. Those that were lost can be handled more directly because they are useless and they should not exist, in fact. So let's discuss about each category. So a kit is a consuming one, suited for disposal. If the document is in idle state for at least a particular amount of time, this amount of time is very important because it tells us that the resource consuming is not generated by user's actions, like scrolling or copy-pasting large data, and so on, but by an issue that comes from inside application. Then the document must consume resources for at least another particular amount of time. This is also important because in some cases the resource consuming is something normal, even if it's not generated directly by a user, like, for example, an autosave with a large document. And of course, there must be a minimum threshold for CPU and memory usage. If these criteria are met, then the kit process is aborted. First, an abort signal is sent to the process, and if at the next iteration the process is still running, then a kill signal is sent to it. There is a set of settings in the configuration file, lulwsd.xml, to which these criteria can be customized and where a set of default values are provided, and to which you can enable, disable this cleanup. A kit is considered lost if it's not referenced by LulWSD in either new children or dog brokers maps for a particular amount of time. Again, this amount of time is important because there are cases when a kit process is up and running but is not referenced by LulWSD. For example, right after it is spawned and before it establishes a connection with LulWSD, which triggers a registration of it. This amount of time can be set in the configuration file and has a default value of 2 minutes. If you pass a value of 0, the cleanup is disabled. Also, there is a metric exposed through the REST endpoint, which counts the number of lost kits terminated processes. For those who doesn't know, there is a REST endpoint which provides a set of metrics in a Prometheus compatible format. This was created because we needed that and we use it heavily. Okay. So, our experience. Well, we are using it successfully for almost 2 years, and it proved to be critical for the stability of our system in some situations. Below you can see a graphic which shows the evolution in time of the CPU usage of each pod. Each colored line represents the CPU usage of a single pod. So at the time we introduced a bug which had the effect of disabling the cleanup mechanism of lost kits, and suddenly we started to receive alerts from Kubernetes that there are pods that are using too many resources for too much time. You can see on the left side of the graphic that there are pods which are heavily consuming CPU. So after we fixed the issue and redeployed the application, the problem disappeared, as you can see on the right side of the graphic. And this is how a healthy deployment of the application should look like. Okay. What I want to mention is that here, this is a soft case. We experienced much more severe cases, but unfortunately I found only this graphic in my screenshots archive. Last numbers shows us that there are between 100 and 200 lost kits dismissed per 24 hours, most on conversions. between 50 and 100 resource consuming kits dismissed per 24 hours, all on editor. Why on editor? Because this is not applicable to conversions, because the idle time property has no meaning in this case for conversions. Okay, all I want to mention is that we are right now we are using a slightly older version of Collabora Online. So these numbers were generated by that version. And we are in the middle of the of process of upgrading to the latest version of Collabora Online, which I expect to be more stable, and most probably these numbers will be much lower. Okay, so at the end, I would like to say thank you to Collabora Online and LibreOffice communities that made this application possible, available, and very useful. Okay, so thank you.
Thanks a lot, Gabriel.